The Pendle Bursary, as far as I know, is unique. Its aim is to encourage and enable young, aspiring musicians and to support them in the most effective way possible. When potential performers apply, they are expected not only to give details about their experience and the standard that they have reached, but also to indicate what they feel would benefit them most and ensure that their progress as a performer is enhanced still further. Maybe it's tuition with a particular tutor, a masterclass, a specific course run only in a conservatoire here or abroad. Maybe it's a better trumpet, lessons in composition with a specific composer. So many ideas and so many different ways in which the bursary can help. There are so many ways in which performance can be enhanced and developed through the bursary. And if appropriate, there may be the opportunity to perform with professional orchestra. The chairman and the secretary of the bursary keep in touch with the winners of the bursary and are always delighted to hear of their experiences as a result of receiving the help the bursary can provide. For me, as an adjudicator, is a very special experience. I hear many varied programmes on so many different instruments, performing programmes ranging from medieval to the 21st century in a wide range of genre. So sit back, enjoy the programmes from these fine performers.
I'm 22 years old and I'm a soprano originally from Leeds in West Yorkshire. I'm currently in my final year of my undergraduate degree at the Royal Northern College of Music in Manchester, where I am studying vocal studies and opera under the tutelage of Sandra Dugdale. It was a huge honour to have been chosen as a winner of this year's Pendle Young Musicians Bursary, and the news came at a time when basically all my other musical activity had come to a standstill due to the coronavirus pandemic, so it was really, really lovely to have something to be able to celebrate. Difficult and different year for all of us, not least those of us who are musicians and performers. I am really grateful to the bursary for providing me and the other winners with lots of opportunity for some online music making when live performance just simply isn't possible at the moment.
Yeah.
Lockdown has been a very difficult and challenging time for musicians everywhere, and it has brought about a complete change to life as we know it. And I myself have had to do quite a bit of adapting to get used to all the new challenges that come with things like recordings and online concerts. However, I have been very fortunate during my time at home to have still kept busy, and most recently took part in two online concerts with my vocal group, Castor Voices, that is made up of six sopranos, all currently studying at the RNCM. I would like to share with you now a clip from our concert back in July for the North Wales International Music Festival. In July this year, I hope to continue lessons with my current teacher in order to expand my repertoire and gain some more vocal maturity before hopefully embarking on further conservatoire study in order to help me along the way to achieving my dream of working as a professional singer. Opportunities they have provided me with, and for the generous financial support, without which achieving my goal of further conservatoire study would be made all the more difficult. I really, really hope to be able to perform for them and for you live somewhere in the not too distant future.
Hi, my name is Benjamin Hartman Booth, though most people call me Benji. I'm a horn player and I'm currently studying for a Master of Arts in Music Performance at the Royal Academy of Music in London. And I'm also one of the prize winners of Pendle Young Musician Bursaries 2020 series.
Thank you.
To begin with, thanks are in order. The prize money which Pendle have so generously given me has allowed me to make the rather difficult transition from an academic undergrad in a completely different field to a vocational postgraduate course, the subject of which I am truly passionate about, and for that I owe them a great debt. The past 12 months have been difficult for us all, and the performing arts sector has been hit especially hard. In my own personal experience, since the summer I've had 2 music tours cancelled. I had to sip my finals exams from the admittedly reasonable comfort of my bedroom, and of the 2 terms at which I've been a student at the Royal Academy, I've only actually been able to spend 1 of them in London. Nonetheless, lockdown doesn't mean that the world stops, and I've been fortunate enough to continue receiving lessons with my teachers through a virtual medium, despite my being in Manchester rather than London, and I've been able to continue to develop and progress as a musician and a horn player with Mike Thompson, Martin Owen and Richard Watkins, 3 absolutely fantastic musicians, and despite the occasional technical glitch, I really feel like these lessons are enormously beneficial for me as a player and a musician. To do with my musical career is get an orchestral seat and perform regularly and frequently with orchestras. I just love the camaraderie of the orchestra and the epicness of the music making and the variety of colour that you can create with such a large ensemble of such varying instruments and varied repertoire. I think the orchestra is, it's where I want to be.
Thank you. Hello everyone, my name is Madison Good and I'm currently studying at the Junior Royal Norfolk College of Music on Saturdays. I've just recently accepted a place at Trinity Laban in London to further my studies next year. I'm incredibly grateful to PYNB because from the prize money I was able to purchase a brand new alto saxophone which I'm going to play in this concert. I'm also planning on spending some of the prize money on some equipment to build a home studio so I can record some of my original songs. So today I'm going to be playing the first and second movements of Four Pictures from New York by Roberto Molinelli. The first movement is called Dreamy Dawn and the second is Tango Club. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. My name is Rose McLaughlin. I'm 18 years old and currently in my first year at the Royal Northern College of Music in Manchester, where I study piano with Helen Chrysos. It's a great shame that we're unable to do this concert in person, but I'm hugely grateful to Pendle Young Musicians for providing this wonderful opportunity and also for the ongoing support that we received through lockdown. A month spent away from the stage has been tough on all musicians, but it's also given us the chance to discover new ways to share music. I was lucky enough in the summer to do 2 online recitals and also receive a prize in an online piano competition. This evening I'm going to be playing Liszt's Concert Study La Leggerezza, which means the lightness, and then to finish Rachmaninoff's Etude Tableau Opus 39 No. 1. I hope you enjoy, thank you very much. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Bradley Crow and I'm 18 years old from Blackpool. I'm currently studying my 3 A-levels at the Kirkham Grammar School, and at the weekends I study at the Junior Royal Northern College of Music in Manchester. I'm very happy to say that in September I will be starting my 4-year undergraduate degree at the Royal College of Music in London. Because of COVID-19, all the auditions were online, so this included me having to record my own pieces at the Royal Northern College of Music and then sending them off to the panel. This was very new, I've never done anything like it before, so I want to share with you the last time I played with an accompanist, which was when I performed the 4A Fantasy for one of my audition tapes. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. bursary has supported me in so many ways. Thanks to their help, I've been able to carry on funding my tuition fees for the Junior Royal Northern College of Music every weekend. I've also had the amazing experiences of working in masterclasses with some of my favourite flautists, being James Galway and Michael Cox. Also, the bursary has supported me through my music conservatoire auditions. The price of these was very high and it was all covered and have assisted me into getting me into my dream conservatoire. I believe that lockdown has been a difficult time for every musician. I think the lack of performances and the lack of playing with other people and the worry about a successful career after this pandemic has impacted a lot of people. However, I've been very lucky and very fortunate to have taken part in some online activities that have kept me busy. Some examples of these are taking part in competitions such as the British Flute Society and the New Youth Talent Music Competition, and also having residencies online such as the National Youth Orchestra of Great Britain, the Orford Music Academy and the Galway Flute Academy. Without the Pendle Young Musicians Bursary, I would not have been able to experience a lot of these things, and I am very, very thankful for all the support I have been given. Thank you.
When I was about 9, so roughly 10 years ago, and that's led me to the Royal Academy of Music, where I'm a scholar studying in my second year of undergraduate. From the moment I started playing harp, I knew I wanted a career in the music industry, and I particularly enjoy orchestral work and outreach work. For me, there's nothing like these two things. With orchestral work, there's just this amazing feeling when you're working with 60, 70, 80 other like-minded people to create something that's bigger than you. And then with outreach work, I adore it because you can see the difference that it makes to somebody right there and then, without any of the glamour of being on stage or anything like that. There's been times when I've gone into care homes and they've all been sat quietly, but as soon as I've started playing a piece that they know well, or even one they sort of recognise from a movie, they start singing, dancing, even just tapping their foot, and even if they forget it within the next hour or so, you know that you made them happy for the 5 minutes that you were playing that piece. Super helpful in terms of future-proofing myself. With the music industry taking such a hard hit, a lot of people have had to become more innovative and more tech-savvy. So I ended up purchasing the camera and microphone that I'm using to film this, and have used to film all of the other clips in this video. It's been so handy because I can use it as a microphone, a joint camera and microphone, but also a webcam. So I've been able to use it for my online lessons. I've had masterclasses using it. I've sent recordings to my chamber music partners. I've done so much with it, and it's also provided the opportunity to record videos for outreach work whilst I can't go in and perform live. I also bought a laptop to go alongside this microphone because my laptop before was so old, it was so slow, it could basically just about process a Word document, so none of this would have been possible without my laptop. And also because my whole course at university is now online, that's been another reason to buy this laptop and increase my musical education. I also, in terms of the future-proofing myself, have found that the microphone's been useful for auditions. And I've also set up a website that I've used the microphone to record clips onto, so when we come out of the pandemic, which is hopefully soon, fingers crossed, people can start taking bookings through my website and we can start getting back into some form of work. Tough on so many people for so many reasons, but there have been some positives that I've noticed that have given me some sort of hope for the music industry once we come out of this. I've seen institutions like the Royal Opera House and the National Theatre, alongside individuals with their chamber music groups or just solos even, upload videos to YouTube and other streaming services, which have reached such wide audiences, from people who are regular concert goers to people that have never ever seen an opera before or never seen a ballet before. And I think that's amazing, because I think now that they've had a taste of it, that once we're out of this pandemic, they'll go, you know what, I really enjoyed the opera that I saw on YouTube, I wonder what one's like in real life. So I think the concert take up will be greater, and also the fact that people just want to go out and enjoy themselves.
I'm Emily Crichton, I'm from Failsworth in Greater Manchester, and I'm studying in London at Guildhall, where I started my master's course this year after spending 3 years studying for my undergrad degree in Oxford. I study on the orchestral artistry course there, so I've already had these amazing opportunities to have classes with LSO musicians, and one time we even had a Zoom class with Simon Rattle, so that was pretty cool. Since starting my Masters, I've been working on my playing, formed a few new chamber music groups. It's so amazing to have real live music again. I was lucky enough to play in the chamber orchestra in my first term at Guildhall, playing the full ballet version of Pulcinella and Prokofiev's Classical Symphony with Joshua Weilerstein conducting. I completed my undergrad degree during the first lockdown, which came with some challenges, and then started a new degree in the next lockdown. Like many musicians, I've struggled with lack of motivation, because we haven't been able to safely play music together for over a year now, and that's what we love doing. So little challenges and short-term goals have really helped me get back into oboe shape. Just trying to find new ways to enjoy playing, because what we love doing as musicians is playing together, and there hasn't really been that much opportunity, so we've kind of got to work out a new way of playing together. I guess some good things have also come out of lockdown. So,
I mean, as musicians we don't usually have any time, so I used to be doing rehearsals literally every day during Oxford, and now, because that's not really a possibility, we've got time to actually focus on our practice and work out what we're doing right and wrong and what we need to do, and that's quite nice actually. It's a welcome break.
It's been quite challenging to find ways to play with other people during lockdown, but I actually did some collaboration over the internet with a group called Bandwidth, with a few friends from Oxford, and it was really interesting because we had to find a new way of playing together, even though we couldn't necessarily hear each other together. And that's one of the interesting things about playing over Zoom and over the internet. You never quite know what's going to happen, but sometimes it has really amazing results. I'd love my future career to involve playing in an orchestra, and the goal is a cor anglais seat because it's just my favourite place to be. Here's the first movement of the Poulenc Oboe Sonata, which I've currently been working on. It's one of Poulenc's last works, dedicated to the memory of Prokofiev. I'm incredibly grateful for the support and opportunities that Pendleham Musicians Bursary has given us so far. They're such a lovely team of people, and I wouldn't be able to fund my course without this sort of help, so I'm really happy to have been a part of the competition.
Hello and welcome to my virtual concert showreel. I'm going to be playing you two pieces today, one called Majinsky's Sonata, where I'll be playing Movement 1, and the other called Turning by Rob Buckland. I hope you enjoy it. Up next, we decided to do a duo by Rob Buckland called Turning. Now, when I was coming up with the idea of what to do in the concert, I thought, what could you not do in a normal concert? So that is why I came up with the idea of duetting with myself, and we hope you enjoy it. Once again, Turning by Rob Buckland. Overall, we really hope you enjoyed this concert
and showed something that you couldn't normally do.
And we hope that it sparked some interest in people that are watching it maybe to go and do something similar. Now, we're going to
head over to Matthew in the future.
See you there. Hello, me again. I thought I'd just take a few minutes to explain who I am, where I'm studying, what my future plans are, and how I've worked around the lockdown and done stuff online. But first, I'd just like to say a huge thank you to the people that organised the bursary scheme. It's been absolutely fantastic for me. With your help, I've been able to look towards getting a soprano saxophone of my own, which is just something that I've been looking forward to for ages. And because of you, I've finally got the funds to be able to get one, and one that I can play professionally in concerts to come. But I'd also like to say thank you for the opportunities that this bursary has opened. Without this bursary, I would have never been able to do some of these performance opportunities just because of the lockdown. Even if it's online like this one, I'm so thankful to be able to be given this opportunity to perform again. Anyway, a bit about me. My name's Matthew. I am a 19-year-old from West Yorkshire, and I'm currently studying at the Royal Northern College of Music in Manchester. For me, where I'd see myself in the future, I'd like to be a solo performer, whether that's on saxophone or in my solo career as, I'd like to say, alternative pop artist. In the lockdown, I've done a few songs and I've recorded and released them on Spotify and iTunes and Apple Music and things like that. So I think if I was to lead that question in to what I've done in the lockdown, I've self-taught myself how to use a digital audio workstation like Logic, and I've learned how to mix, master, produce and record and write my own songs and put them online. I've also been involved in a load of collaborative projects. So I was involved in a lo-fi project, that's sort of a jazzy, chilled music genre, and we released an album, a collaborative album on Spotify called Uncertainty by Wonderful Musicians, and that was just absolutely incredible because there were people from all over the world able to come together. I really hope you've enjoyed this concert, and I hope to see you all in person. when we can, and I hope you all stay safe and well.